I think so, because we know how to play big games. We've been part of it, even in Champions Trophy and also 2011. So we bring the best out of everyone during those big matches. So yes, we look forward to this, and hopefully it will be a exciting contest. Yeah, see, it all depends on the wicket, how it is. Of course, if you look at the history of SCG, it gives a lot of turn to the spin bowlers, and spinners have actually come out and bowled really well. Yeah, if you see the test matches also here, we played against Australia. Spinners played a huge part. So I feel if it does, we've got the spinners to do it. It doesn't matter to us, because if you look at the tournament, we've taken 70 wickets in 7 games, and it has been distributed by the spinners and the fast bowlers. So it doesn't matter how the wicket behaves, whether it's going to give the fast bowlers a lot of assistance or the spinners. We've got everything covered up in those two areas. Our spinners have really bowled well in the tournament, so the fast bowlers. So it's a good sign to go into the semi-final. Yes, as I said, we just need to keep doing what we've been doing. I think the bowlers have done a fantastic job throughout the tournament. So I just hope they can come out and do it tomorrow as well. It was an important game. We had to win that game, and we were chasing, I think, about 240 odd. So yeah, we pretty much did whatever we wanted to. And as a batsman, over the years, I've learned a lot of things. Certainly, batting up the order has changed my game, my approach towards the game, and the responsibility. I know if I'm batting top of the order, there is a huge responsibility, and I have to take my team through. So every time I go to bat, I always think about that. Doesn't matter if I come on top or not, but I at least try and do that. So yes, I've really enjoyed the last couple of years of batting top of the order. And yes, hopefully, the results we want, hopefully the top of the order can give and lay the platform for the middle order to come. It's good. You must have noticed this throughout the series when we played the test matches against Australia. None of the team backed down. Both the teams were right on each other's faces. So yeah, I mean, it's part of the game, I guess. But I just hope it doesn't cross the line. We all know, as a professional cricketers, there are boundaries which we don't need to cross. So yeah, as long as it's inside those boundaries, we're fine. Let's see, talking about my batting, that's the way I approach, and it was important for me to stay there. Doesn't matter how much balls I have faced, or the scoring rate and all that kind of things, because we lost important wickets at that point of time. So it was important for me to stay in and bat as deep as possible. So I exactly tried that, and eventually, I know my strengths in the end. I've done it before, so I know if I stay till the 35th over, I can always cover up the strike rate or the balls or whatever it is. So it was important for one batter to stay till the end, and it was me. As far as what is happening, I don't know what is happening there in Bangladesh. It's a part and part. It's a part of the game. You've got to accept some decisions. Sometimes you don't accept some decisions, so that's what it is. Yeah, see, as I said just now, I try and keep it very simple. I obviously do things which I feel I need to, whether it's a semi-final, final, or just a league game. I try and keep it very simple. I do things which I need to, and it helps my confidence going into any game, not just the semi-finals. Also, if you play any triangular series or a league game of a World Cup, I just try and keep it very simple. Go with a free mind, not too much of a burden in my head. So that's how I approach any game. See, as a team, I believe we need to stick to our game plans, which is coming hard, and if there are a little bit of banters going around, so be it. There will be times where you will see our bowlers, fielders, getting right on their faces. So yeah, there will be times, but you know, as a team, we have to stick to our game plans and try and execute what we've been doing for the last 7 games.
Oh yeah, that was a good memory. It's very, very much fresh in my head.
Yeah, see, nothing like that. Whenever I wear this Indian jersey, it's a motivation. I don't need someone else to pump me up. It's important for me. Whenever I wear that India cap, I need to go and perform. I know that. I don't need anyone else to come and, you know, talk or whatever it is. So it doesn't matter to me. You know, I bat the way I want to, and nothing. I will make sure that nothing gets into the head, and you know, I just want to play my game. It doesn't matter what people are talking and things like that. I think if you look at probably India and Australia have been playing some good cricket in the last couple of years, and considering the fact that Australia is playing in Australia, they'll get some support, and you know, people love their cricket here. And India, obviously, you know, wherever we played, we've got a lot of support. So hopefully tomorrow again, I think, you know, it will be more blue than yellow.
Yeah,
I think so. Every team has some kind of weakness, and Australia has got some as well. They have definitely struggled against some quality fast bowling. If you look at the game against New Zealand, they got all out for 150. Even the other night in Adelaide, you know, against Pakistan, they seem to be in a little bit of trouble. But overall, they're a good batting unit. There's no doubt about it. But again, we are a different bowling attack. We have to stick to our strengths. So we have our ways to come and counter them. Whether it will be spin bowling or fast bowling, you will see that tomorrow.
No.
When you are away for 4 months, you definitely miss home. There's no doubt. But see, we are here on a mission, and the mission is to win the World Cup. So when we finished the tri-series, I know it was 2.5 months then, none of the guys, you know, thought about going back, or, you know, we were right there, and we just wanted to create a history here. So yeah, it's been tough, but you know, if you look at the way the last 1.5 months has gone, it has been really, really good. So we have to make the last 4 months we have spent here a worth by winning the semi-finals and the finals. So it will be, you know, we don't mind staying even for 5 months there.